would you want a falcon's nose with you on a plane?
Is it because it holds exactly 150 millilitres?
Has this got something to do with their... They've got vents, haven't they? They've got those things on the...
Yes.
To stop them bursting, isn't it?
Well, yeah, not really so much bursting as being aerodynamic.
Well, not
really.
Yeah.
It's like they almost make up like a tunnel in their beak, which is it funnels the air.
Okay,
out.
It is about funneling. Yes. What it is that airplanes used to have a particular problem when they reached a certain speed. So the air in front of them struck a sort of wall of resistance, and it causes the engine to choke. Now you might expect the Falcon to have a similar problem because it can reach speeds of up to 200 miles an hour, which is unbelievable, isn't it? 90 meters per second.
I know that because it's on top trumps.
Yeah. Oh, well, then.
I've got a four-year-old been playing a lot of top trumps.
But it can still breathe because it has a cone-shaped structure within each nostril that directs the air into their air passages. And so engineers studied... I love this. They studied this, and they made a rather similar device, a metallic cone, which now goes in the opening of jet engines, and it allows air to enter the engines even when travelling at supersonic speeds.
Is it bad, though, when a falcon's like, wah, wah, there's one of my friends, and then flies into the rotor and then the plane...
It's bad for the falcon, certainly.
Because that's bird strike. That's a big problem with the hitting the edges. Mm. And the other one is frog strike from the helium frogs.
Straight through. People don't think enough about that, I think. Anyway, lots of birds have improved or helped to improve engineering. So kingfishers have improved the design of bullet trains as well. This is a lovely story. So 1990s, there were the very fast trains making extremely loud booming noise when they got out of a tunnel, and it's caused by a cushion of air which is built up in front of the speeding train while it's in the tunnel, and so it was waking up residents, disturbing wildlife. And there was an engineer working on the problem, and he saw a kingfisher dive into the water one day. And he noticed there was almost no splash whatsoever, and that is because of that lovely, beautiful, long, pointy beak. And he applied the same logic to the trains, and they now have long, pointy noses, and it stops the air cushion building up in front of the tunnels, and it makes them more aerodynamic, and so 15% more energy efficient. Isn't that lovely? Wow. That every time you look at one of those, you can imagine a kingfisher.
Ooh. Do you think they're going to start killing all the birds they don't need anymore? Because we've learned enough.
We've got it.
The engines are working. Yeah. The train is making no sound. Kill the birds.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Please, come on, pick something.